Axum is my favorite web app framework right now. And what I really use Axum for is building out APIs. Since web application framework can be quite generic, Axum fits firmly in the space of providing you routing mechanics that allow you to respond to URLs, incoming and HTTP requests, and give responses. This leaves a lot of room for choosing something like Leptos or Sycamore or U to place on top of Axum to get a rendering or a UI server. Now, there are a number of reasons that I like Axum in general, and some of them even match up with the features that they list in their GitHub repo. Specifically, you can do routing and route requests to handlers without macros, which makes handling errors and debugging your application quite a bit simpler, macros being an additional layer of complexity, even though they sometimes are the right choice. Axum provides a Bevy-like API for requesting data for your handlers. So you can put types into the handlers and it will give you, say, your database connections or something like that. And then the other major feature that I would say impacts my usage of Axum the most is its integration with Tower and the Tower HTTP or larger Tokyo ecosystem. Axum is a web framework that really leans into relying on Tokyo and the Tower service abstraction and things like that to enable sharing of these middlewares and other features that you need in an API for dealing with things like authentication or databases or what have you, which means that you can write a Tower service that isn't specific to Axum, the web framework, but is also more widely usable with an even wider ecosystem. Using this Tower service abstraction means that Axum gets timeouts, tracing, compression, authorization, and more because it already exists in that ecosystem. Today, what we have is Axum 0.6, which contains some significant improvements to the Axum web framework. With the 0.6 release, Axum gets even more Typesafe, gains support for running in WASM environments, and of course has the usual bug fixes. Previously, the way to share shared state, like a connection pool to a database, was to use this extension type that you would layer in with your router. So while this example doesn't have any of the actual fields inside of this app state, we could put as many fields inside of this as we wanted to. This would allow us to basically do that query for that app state and receive it in our handler to be able to use. The problem with this is that you had to remember to put in layer extension app state, or you would get a runtime error when the handler ran. Instead, what we've got now is we're still using this same app state concept, but we've got this new with state function that we layer in with our router that enables us to move that runtime error that we were seeing before if we messed up the extensions into a compile time error by trying to fetch the state in almost the exact same API. So from the user perspective, this doesn't change a lot of what you are actually doing. It changes the names of what you are using, but it doesn't change the concepts and the functionality that you are providing. Additionally, this new state extractor allows us to use subfields of that app state in each of our handlers. So if we set up the HTTP client and database connection pool, maybe inside of our application state, we add that state to our router with state, and then we can query for those subfields in our handler, just in case we don't need everything. Now, Axum also lets you nest routers and merge them in different ways. So for example, using this nest command, we can nest this API router with some API state, but on the root, we have this outer state. And when we merge in, we have even another state. As long as when we define our routes, we specify which state we need, these are all still going to be type safe and get exactly what each of these routes requires, even though we've added multiple different states to our router. In addition to the usability improvements of state over extension, state is also faster. So while extension will still work, it's suggested that you migrate to state if you're currently using extension. In Axum 0.5, you could have a handler that required consuming the request body of the HTTP request that's incoming multiple times. This could result in writing code like this, which serializes the request body to JSON and then asks for the request with the body, but this would fail at runtime. Now in Axum 0.6, this is enforced at compile time, so you cannot write the code that would have caused the runtime error anymore, leading to more type safety for the Axum web framework. The middleware from function makes it easy to write middleware using just regular async await function definitions. Now you can run extractors inside of these async await functions, such as, for example, pulling the cookies out of the HTTP incoming request. In Axum 0.5, nested routers weren't allowed to have fallback APIs that would catch everything. In Axum 0.6, this just works and won't panic. Axum now supports being compiled to WebAssembly by disabling the Tokyo feature. Now, reading this, it may not be obvious what the utility of this would be, because why would you compile to WASM if you're running a Rust binary? But theoretically, I could think of at least two use cases. One of which is pretending to handle HTTP requests using WASM in the browser. So you could pretend to have an API that you're hitting, but you could actually be hitting the WASM. And then Axum would, you know, accept that fake HTTP request and then return the response in the browser itself. The other is that some edge runtimes, so edge functions, which if you're not familiar, are basically serverless functions that are white labeled to a particular company and typically run in their data centers. So for example, if you were on a company with a CDN like Netlify, they would have edge functions that would run in their data centers near their CDNs. While a lot of these edge services allow you to use languages like JavaScript, there is a growing contingent of them that require that you compile to WebAssembly, and this would theoretically allow you to use Axum inside of those edge handlers. So some interesting future-looking developments with WebAssembly support, we'll have to see if it pans out. And of course, there's the usual API design decisions that affect you, or small bug fixes. In this case, automatic trailing slash redirects are removed, so previously a incoming request with a trailing slash would get routed to the same route, even if it didn't have a slash defined. But now in Axum 0.6, you need to specify that you want to handle a slash if you want to handle it. And now in 0.6, Axum also has better support for wildcard routes and regular routes being mixed in the same router. So for example, foo slash star rest or foo slash bar can now be used in the same router, whereas previously Axum thought they would be overlapping and try to prevent you from doing that. Overall, I love to see Axum getting more type-safe. It is one of my favorite web frameworks at the moment, and I really love the deep integration with the Tokyo and Tower ecosystems. So if you haven't checked out Axum, now's a great time to do it. And if you have, well, 0.6 is out, so it's time to upgrade. I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.